a really close race, like we're like an inch from away from the finish and we could get first, what's going in my mind is just go out for it, go get it. And if you're in the lead, I'm not gonna give it up. This is gonna be definitely ours. I started Row New York in 2003 as a freshman, and I'm still on the team. Next year will be my last year, 2007. I didn't know about rowing at first, but I didn't want to play basketball because everybody does that, and everybody expected me to play basketball. So I was like, you know what, I'm just going to try something new. Hopefully I'll like it.
Meaning he was at a party and he needed to know if he needed to get back by 6.
You feel wanted and you feel like they truly care about you. And like, we'll support each other even when we leave Row New York, just because we got to be really good friends here at Row New York. Before like I started rowing, most like all my friends that I had, they were like black. But since I joined rowing, I have diverse friends. Like, it makes me more a versatile person. Like, there's more sides of me.
What was Emily's?
We like to joke, we like to crack jokes, you know, and we like to reflect and talk about rowing. There's usually a room where everybody's like chilling at and talking and, you know, sharing memories. And, you know, at night it's intense because Previn comes in for a meeting and you don't know what he's gonna say. You don't know if you're gonna be taken out of a boat. You don't even know if you're gonna be wrong or not. So it's intense, and like he reminds us of that, like, you know, seize the moment. Don't let this moment pass you by. And, you know, don't take things for granted. And I really like that because it's like, you know, he's more than our coach. He's like our mentor, so that's cool.
Anything we can improve on a little bit, it's just trying to...
Rodeo!
Before I started rowing, I used to be like a big procrastinator, but now I just like to get the job done. I don't think I'll probably be working as hard. I'll probably just be working, you know, just to graduate, but it makes me like push myself, get that 90 in that class or get that 95 on the test. I'm thinking about going to Michigan State. When I went there on my recruiting visit, he was like, Monique, I'm really interested in you. Like, you're my number one choice. We're gonna give you basically a full free ride. We want you. Very rare, like, especially in my neighborhood, to like try to get an athletic scholarship or any kind of scholarships to go to school. My sisters, they thought it was really cool too, because they didn't get that same opportunity, so it's like they're supporting me and they're my backbone and they want me to succeed. They think it's really amazing, and I do too. Definitely, it's up to me, like, how far I want to push myself. You have to be like really dedicated. If you're not dedicated and your heart's not in it, then I don't like really think it's for you. We want people to know who we are, and we want to do good at races. We just don't want to say, oh, hey, we're Row New York. Yeah, we got girls of different diversity, and yeah, we're changing things around. We actually want to, you know, win races. We want to be successful, you know? We know we're making a difference in the rowing world, so we're just paving the way for the future.
Hey, the sun is shining, looking like another wonderful day. My CD collection, trying to find some good music to play. While I'm getting ready to face the world.